Hey, so you may be wondering, when are you gonna start baby step 6? Well, when I started baby step 4 a few months ago, I wanted to give myself some time to get good and comfy with taking 15% of my income and putting it towards my retirement investments. Well, it's not like I wasn't putting 30 to 40% toward debt, so I should have been used to at least taking that amount out of my monthly budget, but I digress. As a recap, to contribute 15% toward my investments, I am putting 6% to my 401k. That is up to my company's match. The remaining 9% is divided out by 5% to my HSA and 4% to my Roth IRA. Those are my 2021 accounts. Now, looking ahead to baby step 6, before starting to pay that extra toward my mortgage, I want to set up a couple savings or sinking funds that I'm pretty excited about, one more than the other, I guess you would say. Now, I'll admit, when I was paying down my consumer debt, I wasn't a huge fan of sinking funds. I tried them, I wrote down the amounts for every sinking fund I wanted to have, but it just didn't sit right with me. And I'm not knocking anyone, do what is best for you. It just didn't sit well with me to have thousands and thousands set up for an expense. Say next year sometime, whenever I could use that to pay off a debt right now. But again, I definitely see the benefit in preparing with your money, of course. At the time, they didn't seem like a natural peace-giving part of my process, but I'm willing to try them again as a part of my mortgage debt payoff journey. So I'm setting up two funds. Now these are in addition to my 6 months living expenses that I have tucked away. The first one is a yearly expenses fund. I am using this yearly expenses fund for several different purposes, and I'm gonna list them out here. One is my HOA fees. This year I pay my HOA fees in two payments of $184 apiece. My car taxes came to about $240, and the inspections were about $45 for both cars. I'm gonna add in my TurboTax fee. That was $150 this year. I didn't have to pay anything for escrow last year, where I was short in my escrow account to cover the expenses. So I am in the future going to include that here. But because I didn't have anything within this last year, I am not going to include it. But that is something I would include in here. My car maintenance, because, you know, of course, 2020 was an interesting year. Within the last year, I haven't had very many expenses when it comes to the cars, more so for Lucy than for Roxy. But that came to about $319. And most of my co-pays were dental co-pays. They average about $63 a visit. I did go to my primary care physician, but that was for preventative care, so that was covered. So I am going to add a little bit for co-pays. And I normally go to the dentist twice a year for routine care. So let me add this up. Okay, so all these added up equals $1,245. And this divided by 12 is $103.75 a month. Let's see where I'm gonna put this. And then this amount divided by two for two paychecks a month comes out to $51.875. I'm going to go ahead and round that up to $52 a month. Oops, I messed up there. That's gonna be $52 per pay. Okay, that's pretty feasible. Of course, I can add in expenses I may have missed along the way. I can use this as a base and a foundation, but then also make any changes along the way. But $52 per pay period isn't bad at all. So on to that other fund. Now, the second one is especially going to be a joy to contribute to, and that is a travel or vacation fund. I am so ready to travel more and vacay. It was one of those things that I was looking forward to as I was paying off debt. And I am looking forward to getting out of town. Recently, I took my mom up to Cashers, North Carolina as a late Mother's Day gift. And I'm telling you, it was beautifully relaxing and awesome, and just I absorbed the vibe. It was just great. I was so excited to go, and I so needed to go, that I did a horrible job of packing. I forgot all kinds of stuff. I won't mention them because I'll embarrass myself. But yes, a vacation and travel fund is a must. So for this fund, I'm going with a blanket $5,000. I think that's a great benchmark for international travel and gives me the opportunity and flexibility to get on a flight or take a cruise when I want to, planned or semi-unplanned. Again, $5,000 for the year is what I'm hoping to maintain in that account. I'm also going to use this account for a couple other things in addition to all things travel. My timeshare maintenance fee normally comes out around August. That's between $600 and $700, so I'll use this account to pay for that fee. I'll also use it to purchase a passport and get everything I need for that because I don't have one yet. I'm hoping to get that taken care of by the end of the year, but we'll see. But all of that will come out of this travel and vacation fund. So I will pay these out of that fund. Again, I want to have $5,000 in that account. So let's see here, 5,000 divided by 12 is about $417 a month. So that 417 divided by 2 is about 208.5. So I'll go ahead and round that up to 209. So then adding these two together, 209 plus 52 is $261 per pay period towards my sinking funds. So currently after my bills, my living expenses, and my baby step four contributions, I'm averaging about $1,200 a month extra, or what is left over in an uneventful month. So that minus this amount that I'm putting towards my sinking funds will leave me approximately this amount to put towards my mortgage. Again, that's for a pretty uneventful month. On the low end, I want to try to put at least $500 extra to the principal of my mortgage every month. That is the goal. Using my Capital One 360 account, I'm going to set up these funds and also set up automatic transfers probably every other Wednesday. I think that's what was working before, so that it pulls these amounts from my paychecks. I'm going to set that up today, so as early as next week's paycheck, I will start contributing to these sinking funds, and then I'll adjust from there, see how that feels. And then from there, I'll see just how much extra I'll feel comfortable putting toward my mortgage principal. So yeah, there's joy in the planning. I'm really looking forward to this step. I just can't believe it. It blows my mind. But I'm also really excited about it. And it is the fruit of my labor. So I'm definitely proud of that. Yeah, so I just had to update you and let you know that within the next few weeks, we will start this next debt payoff journey. And let's go. I hope you have a great day. I'll see you next time.